Greetings to all. This is another session in continuation of our series on anthropological theories. Today we'll be discussing about the historical particularism. Okay, so giving a brief background about how it emerged. So this theory basically came as an alternative to the worldwide theories of the sociocultural development, and was proposed by the followers of both evolutionists and the diffusionism school of thought. But essentially it was propounded and popularized by Franz Boas. Basically, it's believed that all the previous theories were kind of unprovable in the nature, and therefore the theories that were proposed by Franz Boas, he was the one who carried further and later on developed by the scholars, essentially his contemporaries like Kroeber, Ruth Benedict, Robert Louis, and many others. So basically, Franz Boas, he rejected the view of all the societies being part of a single human culture and evolving towards a common cultural apex. So because that cultural apex was believed to overcome some empirical problems, one had to carry out a detailed regional studies of the individual cultures so as to discover the distribution of certain cultural traits and then understand the individual process of culture change which is happening at its base. Now, he wanted to emphasize on this process of reconstruction of their histories, and stressed on this meticulous process of collecting and organizing the ethnographic data on various aspects of human societies. He said in order to draw the generalizations on cultural development with expectations of accuracy, the information of different aspects of society must be gathered on the first place. So he believed that there are different stimuli which act in the process of development of a culture, and thus to understand that development, first one must examine the particulars of that specific culture and then therefore identify the source of that stimuli, right? So this theory basically was at an advantage because firstly there were certain historically grounded investigations done, and they were quite more accurate because he was also emphasizing on that reconstruction of histories, and that should have more accuracy towards it based on the ethnographic data. So therefore this theory itself was at an advantage of having grounded investigations, being more precise than the previous models proposed, and secondly it was more easy to demonstrate. Now, in his approach, Boas argued that the history of a particular culture, it lies in the study of an individual trait of a particular culture in a very limited geographical region. So by detailed study from many different cultures as a common frame of reference, an individual cultural trait could be signed out as being borrowed or being invented in nature. Therefore, he essentially stressed upon this importance of gathering as much data as possible, and only then formulating the assumptions and interpretations regarding the culture or culture change. Now, all of this involved the recording of oral history, traditions, their basic ethnographic methods, such as participant observations. And he also stressed upon the importance of all the fields of anthropology in the process of reconstructing the histories. The ethnographic evidences, they were also collected in form of the linguistic evidences. Okay, therefore, because of this holistic approach, this school of thought was known as relying on the four field method of anthropology. Now, this theory essentially stressed upon this fact that each culture is kind of integrated way of life. It is very valid and meaningful in its own context. Moreover, it rejected this idea of ethnocentrism. It, to some extent, promoted cultural relativism, and it was more or less established on the fieldwork or ethnographic methods as essentially emphasizing on this necessity of an anthropological approach. But it was also criticized on certain grounds. For instance, most of the criticisms that were rising up were especially on this issue of data collection, and that it was fearful of making a very broad theorizations, right? Now, because he was constantly insisting on this tireless collection of data, reconstructing theory, ethnographic methods, and a lot more, so he was criticized by his own students like Wiesler. So basically, they said that the data that was collected was a very vast body of the knowledge, and it would be very hard for the investigators to delineate, right? Plus, there will be a lot of data wastage because it's not precisely going, it's not being collected precisely. So, a lot many questions were proposed on the purpose of collecting a lot of detailed work, which one would wish to generate theories on culture development and, for that matter, the process of culture change. Now, there are other contributions that you can look for about that were made by Franz Boas. Basically, he's also called as a father of American anthropology. He has lot many ethnographic contributions that in the field of various domains of anthropology, and he was also pioneering in this four-field approach that he has given. So this was a brief introduction and a brief idea about what is the theory of historical particularism, basically. So for your practice questions, you may write down short notes about a note on the father of American anthropology, his small background if you can give. And second question, what are the theoretical underpinnings of this historical particularism? Thank you.